ISUPK.
Yeah, the ISUPK. Out of 1 West, 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under commanding General Yohana. We teach the so-called blacks, so-called Hispanics, so-called Native Indian man, that you are the real Jews of the Bible.
Right.
There's no slanty eye, no Arab, no white could be the real Jews of the Bible.
Right.
The so-called black man, Hispanic man, a Native Indian man, you are the real Jews of the Bible. And today, we're going to show you the destruction that these other nations did to us. More specifically, the destruction of our women in society. The black woman, the Hispanic woman, and the Native Indian woman have been destroyed by this society.
Good.
They have turned our women into whores. They have turned our women into prostitutes.
Right.
But we are here today to change that. To show you, black man, that you must love the black woman. Hispanic man, love the Hispanic woman. Native Indian man, love the Native Indian woman.
Right.
Our brothers and sisters come across from Venezuela. And our sisters are in whole houses. Our sisters are in every bar and every corner. Every bar has a Venezuelan. Our sisters are being turned into whores.
Right.
By East Indians.
Right.
And by Chinese.
Right.
And by white people.
Right.
They turn our sisters into whores.
Right.
We are here to stop that today. That every Venezuelan sister, every Asherite sister, every black, every Hispanic, and every Native Indian sister will no longer be a whore in this society.
Right.
Our black women are strong, but our black women need guidance. Our black women need protection.
Right.
And we're going to see today in this Bible how a black, Hispanic, and Native Indian woman supposed to be according to this Bible. We're going to show you the order, because there's nothing equal in this society. The black man and the black woman is not equal.
Right.
There is a position. One must be higher than the other.
Right.
There is nothing equal on this earth. And we're going to show you today, according to the Bible, the order and the structure that the black woman and the black man are supposed to have.
Right.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11 and verse 3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
The what?
The head of every man is Christ.
We are going to show you the order how the Most High supposed to rule the black man's family.
Right.
We're going to show you today that the black man is the one who the Most High chose. He did not choose the Chinese. He did not choose the African. He didn't choose the white man. He didn't choose the Arab. But we're going to show you the order today that the black family is supposed to have. Go ahead.
The head of every man is Christ.
The head of every man is Christ. Go ahead.
And the head of the woman is the man.
The head of what?
The head of the woman is the man.
The head of every woman is the man.
Right.
Every woman that lays with a man that has sex with a man that is your husband.
Right.
According to the Bible, you are not supposed to be here, there, and everywhere. But this society will push you to go and sleep with one man here, sleep with the next man here. Because why? He put a ring on your finger. Who tell you a ring validates your relationship? That is white supremacy.
Right.
The minute you open your legs to a man, that is your husband.
Right.
But this society has corrupted the minds of our people to follow the ways of the heathens. Go ahead.
And the head of Christ is the Most High.
The head of Christ is the Most High. So there's an order. There's the Most High. There is Christ. There is man. Then there is woman. There's always order. There's no confusion in the Bible.
Right.
Nobody is equal on this planet.
Right.
Somebody's supposed to be the head. Somebody's supposed to be tail.
Right.
There's no kumbaya. There's no hold hands, let's be together. Somebody must be on top. Somebody must be in the bottom.
Right.
The garbage man cannot be the lawyer. Somebody had to pick up the garbage. Somebody had to be the lawyer. There had to be one people on top, one people at the bottom. And the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man supposed to be on top. And we're going to show today how society has destroyed our communities. Because why? They push the independent woman. Not just the independent woman, they push the independent black woman. They all are here. Independent black woman. Independent black woman. But they ain't telling the Chinese man. They ain't telling the Chinese woman to be independent. They ain't telling the Indian woman to be independent. They ain't telling the white woman to be independent. But they're telling the black woman to be independent. To what? To corrupt the black house.
Right.
Every Indian woman have the Indian man. They ain't leaving.
Right.
The white woman has her husband. She ain't leaving.
Right.
But they're pushing the black woman to leave the black man.
Right.
He ain't good. Get your money. Use an independent black woman and destroying the house of the black community.
Right.
The black woman needs to know her place.
Right.
Just like how the Chinese woman knows her place. The East Indian woman knows her place. The East Indian woman loves the East Indian man. The black woman must love the black man.
Right.
And understand that the black man is to rule the house.
Right.
Not the black woman.
Right.
The black woman supposed to understand that the black man is the head of the house.
Right.
Not the white man. When you look today, who is on child maintenance? How much East Indian is seen on child maintenance? How much Chinese is seen on child maintenance?
Right.
Because why? They push the black woman to put the black man on child maintenance.
Right.
And destroying the black house. But today, we're going to show you how this society was supposed to be, how the black home supposed to be. And the black woman must understand, the Hispanic woman must understand, and the Native Indian woman must understand your place in this society.
Right.
And this is not my words, this is what the Bible says.
Right.
Go ahead, read from the top.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, and verse 3.
This is the word of the Bible. If you was a Christian, you say as a Christian, you say you believe in the Bible, this is the New Testament. So if you disagree with this, then you're a liar.
Right.
And you're a fraud.
Right.
This is what the Bible says about the structure of the household of the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian. If you're a woman, you say you're a woman of God, then you must listen to the Bible. Read.
But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
The head of every man is Christ.
Right.
Go ahead.
And the head of the woman is the man.
The head of the woman is the man. This is the Bible. So if you're going against your husband, you are going against the Most High.
Right.
If you're studying the white man and saying you want to be an independent woman, I don't need no man, the Bible says otherwise. I equal to my husband. There's no equality in the Bible. The Most High said, the man is the head of the woman. And it's time every black home come back to that structure.
Right.
Go ahead.
And the head of Christ is the Most High.
The head of Christ is the Most High. the Most High is not equal to Christ. Christ is below the Most High. They are not equal. There is a structure, the Bible tells you that. We're going to show you today. Black man, Hispanic and Native Indian man, the structure you're supposed to have in your household, that your wives and your children and your daughters supposed to understand that this Bible is the Bible for the Black, Hispanic and Native Indian.
Right.
To rule your house, to keep your house in order.
Right.
Because the Black home is supposed to be in order. That is why there's so much destruction in the Black community. Because the Black house is out of order. The Black woman is out of order.
Right.
And it's time to put that in place. The Black woman, Hispanic woman, needs to know her place and understand that the Black man is the head of the house. Right.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14 and verse 34. Let your woman keep silence in the churches.
This is the Bible. Read it again. If he is a born again Christian, as you say he is a woman of God, this is what the Bible is saying here now. Read.
Let your woman keep silence in the churches.
This is Apostle Paul telling you now that there is no woman supposed to be teaching on no pulpit in the church. Don't vex with me. This is what the Bible is saying.
Right.
If you believe in the Bible, you believe in Paul and in the New Testament, read it again.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14 and verse 34. Let your woman keep silence in the churches.
The Bible saying, let your woman keep silence in the churches. It is not saying that you can't talk, but it's saying anything to deal with the authority of this book or the Bible supposed to be done by the men of the Most High.
Right.
There's no woman to run up on no pulpit and say, bless be the Lord, and want to preach and teach men. No woman supposed to be teaching no Bible on the pulpit.
Right.
The Bible says so. Read it again.
Let your woman keep silent in the churches.
Go ahead.
For it is not permitted unto them to speak.
It is what?
It is not permitted unto them to speak.
This is the Bible, the New Testament. Continue.
But they are commanded to be under obedience.
They are what?
They are commanded to be under obedience.
Your women are commanded to be under obedience. To what? What?
As also said the law.
As what?
As also said the law.
As also said the law. This is the New Testament. So there's no female pastor, no Pastor Gemma, to be coming on no pulpit, to be teaching nobody in the church.
Right.
That is against what the Most High said. This is in the New Testament. Read it again.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14 and verse 34. Let your woman keep silent in the churches.
Let your woman keep silent in the churches. Go ahead.
For it is not permitted unto them to speak.
It is not permitted for them to teach. Go ahead.
But they are commanded to be under obedience, as also said the law.
As also said the law. The woman is subject to her husband. She is to, just like how you have a child. When you have a child in your house, that child has to obey you.
Right.
And your wife is as that structure. Your wife is your property.
Right.
A lot of people don't understand that. They're going to say what? That is your property? Yes. That is according to the laws of God. Your wife is your property.
Right.
Your wife is supposed to understand you is under her protection. She is under your protection. She is supposed to be under your care. She cannot rule you. She is under your house. The Black woman not supposed to rule the Black house. The Black man supposed to rule the Black house.
Right.
There's no equality. But the Christian church will teach you hypocrisy.
Right.
The Christian church will teach you lies.
Right.
The Christian church will destroy your house.
Right.
By teaching you that the woman is supposed to rule the house. The woman is equal to the Black man.
Right.
No. That is not in the Bible. Read that one more time.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14 and verse 34. Let your women keep silent in the churches.
Let your women keep silent in the churches. There's no female pastor to come in and no pulpit to teach any man anything.
Right.
That is the Bible.
Right. For it is not permitted unto them to speak.
It is not permitted for them to speak, to teach God.
But they are commanded to be obedient, to be under obedience, as also said the law.
These are not my words. This is in the New Testament in 1 Corinthians chapter 14 and verse 34. Don't call me a liar, call Apostle Paul a liar.
Right.
If you believe in the Bible, and he is a so-called Holy Spirit filled, and he is a blessed woman, listen to what the prophets are saying. Now we're going to show you how a woman's supposed to be according to the Bible. If you say he is a woman of God, then you must follow these words of this Bible. Your husband is your head. There's no independent woman. There's no I working for more money than you, so I rule in your house. None of that bullshit. That's not supposed to be here.
Right.
The black man supposed to rule the black house.
Right.
There's no equality. The black man is subject. The black woman supposed to understand and learn that she's under the rulership of the black man.
Right.
The Chinese woman understand the Chinese man rule the house. The East Indian woman understand the Indian man rule the house.
Right.
Now why the hell the black woman don't understand that? It's because of Christianity and the Christian church and your pastor. When you're supposed to be cooking food for your husband, you're in the church cooking food for the pastor.
Right.
When you're supposed to see about your children, you're in the church for the pastor.
Right.
The black woman supposed to understand is your husband ruling you.
Right.
Not your pastor.
Right.
Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 31 and verse 10.
Go ahead.
Who can find a virtuous woman?
Who can find a virtuous woman? Go ahead.
For her price is far above rubies.
Her price is far above rubies.
Right.
I love my black woman. That is why I'll come out and say this. Because we love you. Because why? On the streets, who the watching as the whore? Who the watching as the prostitute? Who the watching as the so-called bitches? Pardon my language. When they watch our black women, what they see? All they want to see them as a sex object.
Right.
But the black woman need to understand that you need to change your ways.
Right.
Stop following the philosophies of the television and the music and all these other nations that pushing the ideology that a black woman is supposed to dress a certain way.
Right.
That is what they're doing. When they watch BET and all these music videos, who do they push in front? How much East Indian is seen in them videos? How much Chinese woman is seen? Right. They're only pushing our woman in front to label us and label our woman to be a certain way. But we're going to show you how a black, Hispanic, and Native woman supposed to be. Read.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 31 and verse 10. Who can find a virtuous woman?
Who can find a virtuous woman? Read.
For her price is far above rubies.
Black woman, you are priceless. Black woman, Hispanic and Native woman, we love you. You are greater than any East Indian woman, greater than any Chinese woman, greater than any white woman. Because why? You are God's chosen children.
Right.
This Bible is written for you. Proverbs 31 was written for you, black woman.
Right.
This is your book. And we are teaching you because we love you and we will tell you the truth. Go ahead.
Verse 11. The heart of her husband doeth safely trust in her.
The heart of every black man will rest safely in every black woman who obeys the black man.
Right.
The greatest thing a black woman could do is to obey her husband. Are we seeing today the oppression that our sisters have to go through? the oppression that the black woman has to go through every single day. Sun up to sun down. The black woman has to go to work every day. Because of why? Because of oppression in the society. When she's supposed to be taken care of. The black woman not supposed to lift a finger more than to take care of her household. What?
For all her household are clothed with scarlet.
Go ahead.
Verse 22. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry.
Go ahead.
Her clothing is silk and purple.
That's right. Go ahead.
Verse 23. Her husband is known in the gates when he sitteth among the elders of the land.
Black. Black. Hispanic and Native Indian, we had to understand, each black woman, your husband is your head. And when you respect your husband, you give that respect throughout. Your husband is your head. And when you respect your husband, you show reverence to your husband. And we are here today to teach you and to show you and you must love your husband. Do not be a monster in your house. Because your daughters will learn to be monsters too.
Right.
We are the ISPK out of One West, 121st Street, and New York, and the commanding General Yohana. And with that, I say shalom.
To find something to follow, had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, for this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I'm believing fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord?